Hi everyone, this is Dr. Pasnodi Suman, consultant pediatrician, and this video is regarding the most trending topic all over the social media and news channels over the last couple of days. That is the evidence-based medicine versus quacks recipes. So those who believe this quacks recipe as a cure to COVID-19, please do watch the video till the end. Before going into the details of our topic of this video, I would like to discuss few important points from our history. As everyone are watching what's happening in this COVID-19 pandemic, but this is not the first time we are facing these challenges. You can see the picture here showing the history of pandemics and the death toll they have caused to the mankind over the years. To explain how we have dealt all these pandemics, I would like to discuss an example of what happened in this cholera pandemic. Same like first and second waves of COVID-19, cholera pandemic had 6 outbreaks from 1817 to 1923 year and causing 1 million deaths. Is now nowhere seen because modern water and sewage treatment systems have eliminated its spread by contaminated water. In the same way, we are going to end this COVID-19 pandemic too from our progress in scientific research. One more from our history. This is for those who believe or claim that everyone in olden days have lived minimum of 100 years. This is not to disappoint you, but life expectancy in India was 25.4 in the year 1800. And over the course of next 220 years, it has increased to almost 70. Point to be noted here is, it is out of 10 to 15 children your great-grandparents had, only 2 or 3 used to make it and rest of all dies. But now, even a 600-gram baby delivered at 5 months of age also survives. All this credit goes to only and only scientific progress that we have achieved over the years. Now, we'll go into the details of our topic, evidence-based medicine versus quacks recipes. Now, we'll see the definition of quack. It's nothing but a fraudulent or ignorant pretender to medical skill. It's a person who pretends professionally or publicly to skill, knowledge or qualifications he or she does not possess. Whereas, modern medicine is defined by tremendous advances in understanding of human health and the ability to moderate the course of chronic diseases and correcting disabling physical conditions and curing molecular deficiencies. When we say modern evidence-based medicine is the best possible treatment for any illness, many people start questioning its reliability by asking, if science is so great, why medication like remdesivir, favipiravir and etc. have failed in curing COVID-19? For your information, no one announced them as permanent cure for COVID-19. Please remember, evidence-based medicines are not cooking recipes to be prepared over the night from their own trials in their kitchens. And now comes the most happening question asked by people, that why can't we give acceptance for emergency usage of quacks herbal recipes regarding the one which claims to cure COVID-19 with just 2 drops in ice. One important clarification to be remembered for the rest of your life. If you put 2 drops of any medicine or recipe in any of your natural orifices in the body, not even 0.5% of it reaches your bloody circulation. And to the ones who are questioning how come this virus enters through these natural orifices and spreads into the whole body. Because they replicate in every possible way. Their count increases in millions and millions in a day. Hope you got the answer. Now, before knowing why do any of the quacks recipes can't be given approval for emergency usage for COVID-19, you need to know a little bit of history about the drugs which got approved. Remdesivir is an experimental antiviral drug that was developed by US company Gilead Sciences first for hepatitis C and then as a potential treatment for Ebola and Marburg virus infections. The drug research was started in 2009 and was pushed through clinical trials after the 2013-16 Ebola epidemic in West Africa. And favipiravir is an antiviral medication used to treat influenza in Japan. It is being developed and manufactured by Toyama Chemical and was approved for medical use in Japan in 2014. All these medications and treatment modules like plasma therapy were already in existence since years and were being used in treating and curing other diseases. As we have enough data about the safety and adverse effects of these, and thus considering risk-benefit analysis, these were approved for emergency usage under special circumstances. So, All those who are in a hurry to get benefited by the quacks herbal medicine, you need to know what all to be done as per modern evidence-based medicine. Important disclaimer: all those hardcore believers of quacks recipes, don't watch this video from now, as the facts I am providing might affect your mental health so badly. First point to be noted is, you need permission in writing to the licensing authority to even start your preclinical trials of so-called claimed cure or medicine. I don't know which authority's permission does this quack had to directly start treating people claiming complete cure. There is a big list of what to be done to get that permission to start trials. I have skipped this part for saving your energy. Now we'll go into the details of what needs to be done once you get permission. Now we'll see the different phases of clinical trials. Preclinical study will be done on animals such as rats, rabbits and monkeys. I wonder, how does this quack put those two drops in the eyes of these animals? Coming to clinical trials, in phase 1, there will be estimation of safety and tolerability. In phase 2, effectiveness and short-term side effects are studied. In phase 3, confirmation of the therapeutic benefits, and in phase 4, is nothing but post-marketing trial that is done after drug approval. To those people who have no idea about how many years does it take for a product from the time of discovery to become an approved drug, can see this image here. The average time taken for preclinical trials is 3 to 6 years, and for clinical trials it's 6 to 7 years, and then another 1 to 2 years for review. So an average of 10 to 15 years. Then finally it becomes an evidence-based medicine. Now we'll see the rules and guidelines that should be followed for regulation of drugs in India. You can see the big list of guidelines and rules which needs to be followed to get the drug approval. Now we'll see the various regulatory agencies that are involved in drug regulation in India. Imagine the time taken to get approval from these regulatory agencies. Now you might have understood the reason why all doctors or intellectuals are against such magic recipes which claim to cure COVID-19 with two drops in eyes or by drinking excreta of animals. I wonder why so many will be ready to appreciate and accept these quacks recipes as soon as they hear about their claims of complete cure. Imagine, how can we accept some concoction prepared by any Tom, Dick and Harry who has dreamt it last night, escaping all those authorities and clinical trials? All my efforts into making this video is to bring the awareness about evidence-based medicine. I hope everyone who watched this video will not accept any further claims until they are tested and proved. Thanks for watching, and cheers to all the people who can change their minds when presented with information that contradicts their beliefs.